Every detective story begins with a clue overlooked. In the aging brain, it isn't just amyloid plaques or tangled proteins, it's a missing currency, an energy form that powers the cell's cleanup crews. Without it, garbage builds up, neurons slow down, and memory begins to fray. Recently, researchers uncovered something surprising. Two familiar natural compounds were able to bring that currency back, and with it, the cell's ability to take out its own trash. In just 24 hours, worn-down neurons regained energy, cleared toxic proteins, and reduced the stress that drives degeneration. What are these compounds, and what does this discovery mean for how we think about cognitive decline? As the brain ages, energy begins to run short. ATP production drops, especially in a place like the hippocampus, a region that carries the heaviest load for memory and learning. That deficit fuels oxidative stress, while the cleanup system, autophagy, slows down. And here's the twist. Autophagy isn't powered by ATP alone. It depends on another energy currency, GTP, to drive vesicle trafficking and protein clearance, but with age, NAD plus levels fall, cutting off the very precursors needed to keep GTP flowing. Neurons become starved of the energy they need to take out the trash. Now imagine if there were simple natural molecules, compounds you could find in a vitamin or even in a cup of tea that could recharge this hidden energy system. Two such molecules have caught scientists' attention in a very recent finding. One feeds the NAD plus pool, the other a green tea antioxidant that flips on the brain's antioxidant defenses. Together, they appear to do something very unique, restore lost GTP and give old neurons back their ability to clean house. That's the story behind a new study from UC Irvine. Before we go any further, it's important to be clear. The study we're about to unpack was done in neurons from aged mice and in Alzheimer's model mice. This isn't a clinical trial and it doesn't prove that the same effects occur in humans. What it does provide is a window into mechanisms we can then compare against human data. So in this episode, we'll walk through what the researchers saw in the lab, and then we'll bring in findings from clinical studies to see how it all lines up. The UC Irvine team started with a simple question. If declining GTP is a bottleneck in aging neurons, can we restore it? To test that, they cultured hippocampal neurons from aged mice, tracked live GTP levels with a fluorescent sensor, and asked what happens when you add back two natural compounds. The results showed that free GTP levels, which normally collapse with age, rebounded within 24 hours when the cells were treated with nicotinamide, the vitamin B3 amide, and EGCG, the green tea antioxidant. That recovery reactivated vesicle trafficking, lowered oxidative stress, and cleared amyloid aggregates, essentially giving old neurons back their cleanup function. So why do these two compounds, nicotinamide and EGCG, make such a difference in aged neurons? The answer lies in how they feed into two complementary systems. Nicotinamide is a form of vitamin B3 that feeds the NAD plus salvage pathway. NAD plus is the gateway to guanine nucleotide synthesis. Without it, neurons can't efficiently make GMP and GTP. By restoring NAD plus availability, nicotinamide reopens the supply line for GTP. And that GTP is what fuels small GTPase enzymes that drive vesicle trafficking, endocytosis, and ultimately autophagy. EGCG works from a different angle. It's a polyphenol from green tea that very rapidly activates NRF2. That's the transcription factor that turns on antioxidant defenses. Importantly, first line of defense enzymes. Within 30 minutes, EGCG drives NRF2 into the nucleus and increases expression of enzymes like glutathione peroxidase, superoxide dismutase, and more, countering the oxidative stress that otherwise paralyzes trafficking pathways. Put together, nicotinamide supplies missing fuel and EGCG protects the machinery that uses it. The result, vesicles move again, lysosomes fuse, and amyloid cargo gets cleared. In effect, the energy system and the defense system come back online at the same time, restoring a cleanup process that had ground to a halt. Now, that was all neurons from aged mice. The real question is, do we see anything like this in people? Let's start with the energy side. In humans, brain imaging shows that brain NAD plus levels decline with age, and those reductions track directly with ATP production. In other words, the same energetic bottleneck seen in mouse neurons shows up in living human brains. And there's proof that you can move this system. In Parkinson's patients, 30 days of supplementation with nicotinamide riboside at 1,000 milligrams boosted brain NAD plus levels and shifted cerebral metabolism on PET scans. That doesn't prove benefit for Alzheimer's, but it shows the pathway can be engaged in people. Nicotinamide itself has also been tested in early Alzheimer's in the phase 2 NEAT trial. Patients received 3 grams per day for 48 weeks. It was safe, but it didn't shift tau biomarkers. The likely reason? Most of the nicotinamide was inactivated in the bloodstream before it reached the brain. That detail echoes exactly what the UC Irvine team warned about. Delivery matters. What about the green tea compound? In healthy adults, a single dose of green tea extract containing 300 milligrams EGCG has been shown to enhance parietal-frontal brain connectivity during working memory tasks on an fMRI. In older adults with mild cognitive impairment, a blend of green tea catechins plus 60 milligrams of L-theanine daily improved working memory and attention span over 16 weeks. Other trials using 1 to 2 grams of green tea catechins over 12 months have shown mixed results, sometimes no clear cognitive benefit, but consistent reductions in oxidative stress markers. And in an entirely different context, cardiac amyloidosis. Patients taking 450 milligrams of EGCG daily from green tea extract showed reductions in amyloid burden in the heart muscle over a year. It's not the brain, but it's compelling evidence that catechins can remodel protein aggregates in humans. Put together, the human data doesn't yet confirm what UC Irvine saw in a dish, but it points in the same direction. Energy declines with age, B3 derivatives can raise NAD plus in the brain, and green tea catechins can alter connectivity, memory, and even amyloid biology. The pieces fit, though translation is going to depend on dose, formulation, and more long-term trials. The UC Irvine work points in a different direction compared to certain drugs on the market. Instead of pulling amyloid out of the brain with an external tool, the goal is to repower the neuron's own cleanup crew. By restoring GTP and balancing redox status, neurons might be able to take out their own trash. This theme also lines up with other non-drug strategies that have shown human signals. Ketone therapies, for instance, often in the form of medium-chain triglycerides, provide around 20 to 30 grams per day, can bypass defective glucose metabolism in the Alzheimer's brain, leading to improvements on cognitive scales in certain subgroups. Synaptic support formulas like Sovinade, which combine omega-3s, uridine, and choline, have shown that supplying the right metabolic precursors can slow decline in prodromal Alzheimer's over several years. What makes a UC Irvine approach different is its simplicity. Both compounds are already available as dietary supplements. Vitamin B3 derivatives can restore NAD+. Green tea catechins can flip on antioxidant defenses and, in some contexts, remodel amyloid. It's not proof yet, but it sketches out a path where nutrition and energy metabolism aren't just supportive care. They're part of the therapeutic equation. Of course, there are important limits to keep in mind. The UC Irvine findings come from neurons in culture, not from human brains. What works in a dish doesn't always translate to living people. On the supplementation side, nicotinamide at very high doses, 3 grams per day, like in the NEAT trial, was safe for most participants, but it didn't move Alzheimer's biomarkers, and it can stress the liver in some individuals. Newer NAD plus precursors like nicotinamide riboside show better delivery to the brain, but still need long-term testing. For green tea catechins, human trials have used a wide range of doses. Lower daily amounts, 300 to 600 milligrams of EGCG, are generally well tolerated, but higher intakes, especially from concentrated extracts, carry a known risk of liver toxicity in a fraction of people. That's why clinical studies monitor liver enzymes closely. Finally, while there are signals in Parkinson's disease, mild cognitive impairment, and even cardiac amyloidosis, we don't yet have strong randomized trial data showing that these compounds prevent or reverse Alzheimer's disease. Translation will hinge on bioavailability, formulation, and long-term safety. Until those studies are done, this remains a promising but unproven strategy to maintain cognitive capacity as we age. The takeaway is simple. Aging neurons don't just lose energy. They lose the very currency, GTP, that powers their ability to clean house. In mice, restoring that fuel with nicotinamide and a green tea antioxidant gave old neurons back their ability to clear toxic proteins. In people, the story is still unfolding. We know brain NAD plus falls with age. We know that B3 derivatives can raise it. And we know green tea catechins can alter brain connectivity and even remodel amyloid in other tissues. but the leap to Alzheimer's therapy will depend on dose, delivery, and long-term trials. For now, it's a compelling glimpse at how nutrition and metabolism might one day join the front line in the fight against cognitive decline. Until next time, stay sharp and stay healthy.